Last August on social media, Graham Hancock shared some interesting news regarding North American mounds. The source, and many others available on the internet, refer to a research published in June 2022 in the American Journal of Science. The article is unfortunately behind a paywall, but still some of the content seems to be summarized in the news. And basically, looks like mound building in North America is now much older than previously thought, estimated to be 11,000 years old, very close to the edge of Göbekli Tepe, in Turkey, a very well-known pre-pottery Neolithic site, often cited by alternative researchers. The new dating of the Lousiana State University Campus Mounds is something Graham Hancock could not resist to tweet, because he had already suggested a similar age for mound building cultures in his book America Before. I personally read that as you archaeologists were wrong and I was right. Well, let's check the details of this finding and see the possible implications. Welcome to Ancient Puzzles. Hello, hope you're doing well. So we have a very interesting discovery concerning the Lousiana State University Campus Mounds. Using radiocarbon dating, the authors of the study determined that its construction began approximately 11,000 years ago, but the works continued over several millennia and were not completed until 6,000 years ago. Sediment cores were taken from the two mounds, labeled Mound A and Mound B, and revealed that they were built up in layers, the oldest of which containing ash from burned reeds and cane plants. Amongst the ash, microscopic fragments of charred mammal bones, called osteons, were found, and the team was unable to determine whether they were of human or animal origin. They requested permission to perform DNA tests on the material found, but the Native American tribal communities contacted basically denied it. But this was not the end, because still something quite interesting was noticed by the experts. The structures are aligned with the point on the horizon, that is, 8.5 degrees east of true north, right where the red giant star, Arcturus, would have risen 6,000 years ago. The star in question is among the brightest in the night sky. So, it is good to see archaeologists are considering an astronomical connection. I just wonder if there wasn't another one that could fit, for example, 11,000 years ago. Also, there are some chronological differences when comparing Mound A and Mound B. The datings listed in the cover of the article are a bit confusing, but you can check the abstract to verify the information. Mound A is the youngest, with work starting 9,500 years ago, still very old. Mound B, on the other hand, is the one initiated 11,000 years ago. The distribution of tree roots within the mound suggests they were abandoned for about a millennium, beginning 8,200 years ago, and coinciding with a major climate event affecting the northern hemisphere, with temperatures dropping 35 degrees Fahrenheit or 1.67 degrees Celsius. Construction eventually restarted 7,500 years ago, when the two mounds were about half of their current height, and over the next 1,500 years, they were built up to its present size, roughly 20 feet tall or 6.1 meters. Before this research came out, it was thought that mound building couldn't be older than 6,500 years. One of the two Montesano site mounds, in southern Louisiana, was dated at 6,220 years before present, plus or minus 140 years, and it was unfortunately destroyed for new construction at Baton Rouge. Seems like the result was a bit controversial though, and the Watson Break mounds, located in the floodplain of the Ouachita River, near Monroe, in northern Louisiana, were more accepted to be the oldest, built approximately in 3500 BC. The new dating of the Lousiana State University Campus Mounds has completely changed that, showing mound building is at least twice older than this. That is certainly remarkable and brings to the table another striking fact. Basically, that mounds were built in North America for approximately 10,500 years, since yes, until the 16th or even the 17th century, there were still cultures building them. Maybe there were long periods of inactivity, we don't really know, but somehow, this practice survived until 500 years ago. And I wonder if one of these many cultures building mounds over thousands of years developed some sort of technology or skills capable, for example, of carving something like this. I highly recommend you to watch the video in question and I'll leave you a link in the video description. One of the possibilities is the mound builders had something to do with it, but there's a lot more to the story. It is true that very fine figurines associated with mound building cultures have been found, like the ones attributed to the Mississippian culture, but nothing like the Mystery Stone so far, showing clear signs of power tools. It's just speculation, but who knows, maybe I can declare victory someday, same as Graham Hancock, although it is likely someone suggested this mound builder connection before. Anyways, yes, Graham Hancock was right about mound building being much older, but let's not forget archaeologists are the ones who confirmed, and that this is not what he ultimately claims, which is, basically, that there was a lost advanced civilization during the Ice Age. And by advanced, he means, if I recall, more or less as advanced as we were in the 18th or 19th century. The recent discovery, I don't think it has any implications when it comes to this, and the same applies to Göbekli Tepe and the other Tastepeller sites, similar in age and far more impressive. Graham Hancock usually says Göbekli Tepe has no background, and he suggests we're looking at an attempt of restarting civilization. According to him, the survivors of a global cataclysm during the Younger Dryas period transferred knowledge and technology to Anatolian hunter-gatherers in this case. Okay, it's important to consider all ideas, but of course, taking into account the latest research. I'm not sure if Graham Hancock is out of sight of Malta, 25,000 years old, and Kostenki, going as far back as 40,000 years ago, but he should take a look at the findings, because they show that Paleolithic people were smart and way more developed than what some people think. You can check out the videos by Matt Simpson from the Ancient Architects channel, which clearly illustrate what I'm saying. And in Turkey, we have Bonkuklu Tarla, for example, also older than Göbekli Tepe, so it's difficult to argue against all of this as part of the background, and it wouldn't surprise me at all if something similar is discovered someday in North America, since groups of people more advanced than Clovis could have reached the Americas in the very distant past as well, even before them. The Lousiana State University Campus Mounds, honestly, do not seem to come close to Göbekli Tepe, especially considering that 11,000 years ago were much smaller. Knowing how they were constructed would tell us even more about the difference in development between these cultures, and I sadly found nothing specific about it, but we definitely have some interesting clues which allow us to guess with a high degree of confidence. There is information available explaining how mounds in general were built. Groups of workers gathered baskets of dirt, carried the material where they wanted, dumped it, and dumped it down with their feet. As a result of repeating the process over and over, an earthen mound was born. The earliest mounds seem to have functioned both as public landmarks for seasonal gatherings and platforms for villages, but there is evidence of ritual and funerary purposes as well, as attested by the presence of human and animal remains, often cremated. This sounds very similar to what archaeologists tell us about the Lousiana State University Campus Mounds, so originally, 11,000 years ago, looks like they were essentially a pile of dirt, bones, and ashes, used probably for the purposes we've just mentioned. Maybe they were already astronomically aligned 11,000 years ago, we don't know, but the public information doesn't mention it. And well, saying that all mounds are a pile of dirt, bones, and ashes wouldn't be accurate. Variety of materials have been found. Soil, clay, seashells, mussel shells, and stones. The largest mounds were built out of packed clay and soil, and some might even have secret chambers waiting to be discovered. We certainly have examples of stone chambers in North America built by unknown people that could have been mound builders, and some are made of blocks weighing several tons, reminiscent of the European megalithic monuments. So it would be interesting to see if one of these structures, someday, is dated to around 11,000 years ago or earlier. Last but not least, let's not forget about the giant skeletons that supposedly were discovered in North American mounds. Many alternative researchers have speculated that these people were the original mound builders, and I find this possibility exciting, but there are some things to consider. Lots of old news reported the findings, both in the 19th and 20th century, which is definitely quite interesting at first glance. Some of them could be true, and some not, but surely selling newspapers was enough reason to manipulate information, and that is something to really think about when no physical evidence of the remains is available today. And no, the Smithsonian Institution never admitted to have destroyed giant skeletons, and there is no proof confirming such a thing, but it's a popular hoax on the internet that still many people believe. On the other hand, some of the stories told by European settlers claiming to have encountered giant natives could very well be exaggeration to sensationalize their survival accounts. Anyways, it's important to keep an open mind, and time will hopefully tell whether it's true that giants existed and built the first mounds or not. To conclude, as I told Graham Hancock, the new dating of the mounds is of course important, but proving the lost advanced civilization ever existed requires a lot more than that. Thank you so much for watching and hope you enjoyed the video. If so, drop a like, share your thoughts in the comments, and consider subscribing if you haven't yet. I'll see you in the next one. Bye!